Coming up in this Brightline Construction Update. This update looks at the other Cocoa Tunnel, located just east of the Interstate 95, State Road 528 interchange in Cocoa, Florida. Here, the tracks will use the new tunnel to shift from the north side of State Road 528 to the south side before it crosses over Interstate 95. Following the filming of my video flying through the Cocoa Tunnel, which you can see at the link above, the people from Brightline brought me over to this tunnel site, which is just a few miles west. This tunnel is being built from precast curved concrete panels, which are being built here in what is known as the casting yard. Here, rebar is assembled and put into one of the two forms where the concrete is poured. Once cured, the panels are moved to storage, which is located along part of the route the tracks will follow to get to the ramp for the bridge over Interstate 95. This ramp is complete for the most part. A little work needs to be finished at the top near where the bridge will connect. All the pilings are finished for the bridge across the interstate. The beams should be starting to arrive in the next few months. There's also some work needed to finish off the grade at the bottom of the ramp, but that is where the tunnel panels are currently being stored. Work at this location is being done in multiple stages. This satellite image was taken shortly after the land was cleared. A temporary shoe fly was built next to divert State Road 528 onto, so the tunnel could be built in its previous footprint. With that complete, the old lanes of traffic were demolished and work on the tunnel began, along with ramps for the new permanent lanes of traffic on either side of the tunnel. This is the current step of the process. When the tunnel is complete, traffic will be routed onto the new lanes across the tunnel, and then track will be laid through it on the way to Orlando. Work is currently progressing on assembling the prefabricated panels to start building the tunnel. Overall, this tunnel will be made up of 125 individual panels. The remainder of this video will be focused on installing panel 25. The panels are brought over to the tunnel location in the storage area on a specialized truck. They are then unloaded and rigging is attached so the panels can be rotated 90 degrees to be installed. This is where we join in the process. The crane lifts the panel off the ground using one winch instead of rigging, and then uses its second winch and another set of rigging to actually make the rotation. I should note that I have sped up this video for the sake of time. Following the rotation, crews reworked the rigging to prepare the panel to swing into place, which took several minutes. While that was happening, I flew around to get some other views of the tunnel. The large pile of dirt behind the tunnel is the start of the ramp that will eventually carry State Road 528 across the top of the tunnel. One thing you may have noticed is that this tunnel is being built on a curve. To accomplish this, the tunnel panels are built with a compound curve. This makes a tunnel that would be difficult to assemble in a straight line even tougher, since not only do the panels need to align at the top, but they also need to maintain a steady curve for the entire length. Here's a look through the 24 panels that have already been installed. You can see the S-curve the tracks are followed as they go through the tunnel and curve to go over Interstate 95. With the rigging complete, the panel is now swinging over to where it will be installed. The panels are installed in a staggered pattern for increased strength, and so each additional panel can be supported without the need for any secondary supports. The crews have the most flexibility when setting the bottom of the panel compared to the top. Even then, they only have roughly a half an inch of play. When dropped down, they are set on a thin piece of rubber stripping, and any adjustments are made using pieces of plywood. Once crews were happy with the placement of the bottom, they slowly began lowering the top into place. The bottom has to be placed exactly, otherwise the top joint will not line up properly and they would have to start again. Two crew members used a lift to monitor the joint and help if any adjustments are needed. Once everyone was ready, they lowered the piece into place, then began checks to ensure it was secure before removing the rigging. Crews have determined that they are safely able to install 4 or 5 panels a day. Once all of the panels are installed, crews will pour concrete along the bottom of the panels on the inside of the tunnel to permanently secure them into place. Dirt will then be brought in to cover the tunnel in preparation for routing the road over the top. Traffic will likely be crossing it before the end of 2021. Thank you. I would like to thank Brightline for letting me come and document this process in action. Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. Also check out my social media pages.